I'm quite sure you all may have heard about this mentality, no pain, no gain, or balls to the walls mentality by working out. Well, here's the bummer. The degree of truth in this statement is very less. Firstly, you should differentiate between the term pain and soreness or pump. Most of the time we are suffering through an injury and we think we can surpass it by working even harder. If you're thinking that way, ditch that idea right away. Focus on rehab exercise, take a day off, and do not think if you would take a day off, you would go back to your original state. In fact, weightlifting is not a linear process. You take few steps forward and then few steps backward, and thus the cumulative effect of that journey. Moreover, secondly, there's a term known as RIR, which means reps in reserve. By working out and in initial weeks of your mesocycle, you should focus upon leaving most of the reps in your tank. That means that you should work out to an extent that you feel like, okay, I have four more reps more back in reserve, and I should probably don't bring my ego there and leave it right there. And next week I can progress on the weight and decrease our RIR, and then finally reaching the final week of mesocycle and thus finally hitting the 10 RIR. You should always focus on increasing your mesocycle by 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In fact, most of the studies have shown that the best hypertrophy is achieved at almost like 6 to 8 RIR. So that's also no pain, no gain mentality is totally doesn't hold at that point. Thirdly, in powerlifting, or if your focus is power building or strength, then there's this concept of RPE, rate of perceived exertion. Even that kind of is an analogy to RIR, kind of complement of RIR. And it states that you shouldn't go to RPE of 10. 10 means, okay, this was the best I could give, and I cannot do more rep than that, and this is the personal best of the given range of reps. So even here, if you are trying to progress in your powerlifting mesocycle, you should start with your mesocycle somewhat like 6 RPE, 7 RPE, then 8 RPE, 9 RPE, and finally 10 RPE. If you think that I should go and give my best every week, you may get to a place but never to your destination. There would eventually come a point where fatigue will hit you like a truck, and then that's that. If you won't take a deload, your body will take a deload for you, and hence no pain, no gain doesn't hold even here. So take care, stay safe, train smartly, have a smart plan with you, keep your ego outside of the gym. Definitely peaking can be achieved after a mesocycle and you can go balls to the walls mentality, but most of the journey of your training cycle, like almost 90% of your time, it should be taking into consideration of the fact of smart concepts like RIR and RP. Thank you, stay safe, and Mahadev.